Hey guys, I have another dissection for you today, and this time we're going to be taking a look at the second version of My Horse Staircase. Once again, this isn't a tutorial, the link to that will be in the description below, but I will give a quick demonstration of what this does. So if I flick this input here, the staircase will open and we could just walk right down. And what makes this special compared to a regular player staircase is that this actually retracts one more block than necessary for a player to fit through, and that way you can just ride your horse down and the horse will fit as well. Hence the name Horse Staircase, because I totally needed to explain that. Anyways, I have this color-coded here to make it easier for you guys to look at and for me to refer to, but we're actually going to be starting out with this cyan circuit here, which is the input. So the first thing that this input is powering is this pair of dual edges, and actually it's not even really powering them. Instead, these dual edges are butted and it's powering the thing that updates them. So when I flick this lever, as you can see, this piston will extend and that'll just update the dual edge. And like I was just saying, this works off of being butted. This is some pretty standard stuff. This piston is being powered by that redstone block through quasi-connectivity. And when it receives an update, it'll push that up so that redstone block will have a chance to power that repeater. And then it'll be pushed back down and it's ready to go again. Now there's two curious things about this. The first thing is, what is this dropper doing? As you can see, it's going into nothing and it's even holding nothing. Well, actually, this is part of multiple circuits. In the cyan circuit, it's just used as a block to hold redstone to power that piston. But later on, it's going to be used in what I believe is the lime circuit, if I recall correctly. And that just is used more as a dropper instead of what it's being used for currently, and it makes a lot more sense in that circuit. But for now, you'll just see this being used stupidly as just a block. The other curious thing is, why exactly are we hooking up a lever to a dual edge? Now, if you're more advanced at redstone, you'll know that when you start out a creation, you want to make sure you pick the right input. So when you have something with a repeated action on both the opening and the closing, then usually a button would make more sense, because when you push a button, it does the same thing both times. You push it once, as you can see, it pushes, and then you push it again and it also pushes. With a lever, on the other hand, when you flick it once, it stays on. When you flick it again, it turns off. That's very much unlike a button, because the button does the same thing every time. The lever repeats itself every two times. And when you hook up a lever to a dual edge, you're basically turning it into a button, because that means that every time you flick the lever, the output will flicker like a button. So when you flick the lever like that, that flickers. When you flick it again, that pulses again. So why are we turning this lever immediately into a button through the dual edge? Well, actually, there's two reasons. The first one is, we're not just using this lever into the dual edge. This is just the first use of the lever. It's going to be going into another circuit that I'm going to show in just a couple of seconds. And it makes a lot more sense to have a lever there instead of a button going into a T flip-flop, for example. The other reason is that we're not even really using this dual edge as a dual edge. We're using it as an ABBA gate more. And what that basically means is, we're going to turn it off, or turn it on rather, with this delay where it's basically instant, only like 1.5 ticks of delay. But then the turning off of it, when this lever turns off, we're going to be delaying that later on using another circuit. And that's going to be delayed like 10 or so ticks, more than a second. So it's going to be a while before this turns on again. So instead of thinking of it as a lever going directly into a dual edge, think of it as a lever going into an ABBA. So let me actually show how this fits into the rest of the creation. Let me bring the pistons into here. So here I have added these pistons and this dark gray circuit into the mix, and basically this dark gray circuit is fed directly from the dual edges, and that just powers the pistons that you see in front of you here. So when I flick this lever, as you can see, basically everything pulses, and then when I flick it off, everything pulses again. So these dual edges one tick everything, so that means that it either extends the block or retracts it. And on each side, because this thing is mirrored, as you can see, basically the entire creation is basically mirrored. So for this side, and I guess for both sides in that case, these five pistons, they spit out the blocks. So they spit out these three floor blocks, as well as these two pistons that'll push the floor blocks up to the floor level. And they also retract these two blocks here, which were previously part of the staircase. As you can see, this block and that block get retracted, and we do that to make room for some of the later redstone, which I do not have in place at the moment. That's in a later circuit. Also, the gray circuit, as you can see, pulses these two front pistons here, and those do a really simple thing, which is just pushing the staircase block up to that floor level. Now basically that's all the pistons, all the layout pistons, and the rest of the redstone, like 90% of the redstone that we still have yet to add here, is all dedicated to powering these pistons. So we need to move these six blocks up to the floor level because these blocks are already there. And then also, like I was mentioning, we need to delay the dual edge to turn that into that ABBA that I was just talking about. So speaking of that 90% of redstone, I actually have this red circuit here, which contributes to these next two blocks being made flush with the floor. These two are already flush with the floor, and then we just need to do the rest. And what's really special about this one, these next two blocks, is if you come under here, you may notice that there's absolutely nothing being able to push them up at the moment. So to do that, we actually use these first two pistons again, and this red circuit is used to extend these guys on the delay after this is pulsed, and this will just extend that, push these pistons like this, and then they'll be in place to power alongside the rest of these guys. And so that's what that red circuit does. So to power those pistons, we have this green circuit here, and now this is where the dropper comes into action as actually being a dropper. This is the same dropper that I was pointing out earlier, and that goes into this hopper. So when this is powered, it sends the item into the hopper and it stays there because it's being strongly powered by that dust. And this block is actually the block that is used in the dual edge, so that's pretty cool because both the dropper and that block are being used for multiple things. And because this is butted, let me just have a simplification there, I don't have the redstone block, but when this is pushed back down, remember the circuit is butted again, it doesn't actually push the block back up, and then we could just use that to send the signal through from the hopper. So that's pretty neat. And then from there, it's just a straight shoot into those pistons. You can see it's pretty simple, it just goes through the comparator, into the torches, and then powers these two pistons there. Now, the other cool thing about this circuit is that this site, this green block here, is actually the floor block from the staircase. You could actually go back a couple seconds and then see that these were actually brown blocks before because they're part of the floor, but now we're using them to power the pistons, so now they're part of this lime circuit. So if you imagine those pistons being powered, then the blocks would be pushed to here. And then the last thing we have to worry about is the remaining four pistons here. So to power them, we just have this purple circuit here. And also I just hooked it up to this rinky-dink little lever and dust. In reality, this is not part of the creation. That would be the lime circuit, which would be powering these purple things. But to make it simpler, I just hooked it up to some dust and a lever. Anyways, I can just activate this and we could see what it does. As you can see, we actually have a double piston extender here, or two double piston extenders actually, and each one of those is holding a redstone block. And what's pretty neat is that this actually accomplishes both the extension and retraction for both sets of sticky pistons. So if we see here, the back sticky pistons, they actually spit up the block because they get one ticked from the redstone block moving so quickly, and then these remaining two pistons stay powered because the redstone block stays there. And then when the redstone block retracts, once again these two retract, and then these two receive a short pulse that allow them to retract the block back into their final position. So that's how this double piston extender works. It's pretty simple. Here we have a torch on the underneath of this block, and then that feeds into these two tick repeaters, which goes into the dust into more two tick repeaters. And actually, you could save a couple resources. You could save a dust or something, I think, by rearranging this differently, but to keep it nice and symmetrical, I just have it like this, and it's really not that big a deal to save a dust, I guess. So now I can talk about the ABBA circuit again, because we basically just saw how almost the entire creation works. We saw how it extends, and we also saw how these pistons retract. Now the only thing that's left is for these pistons to grab the floor pistons back into their final positions. And if you notice, we can't do that with the same timing that we extend them with. So we extend them basically instantly, as fast as we can from the lever turning on. But when we retract it, we actually wait a little bit, and we need to do that because all the shenanigans going on here take time. So when these things retract, we have to wait for the green circuit to turn off. We have to wait for the dull piston extender to retract. We have to wait for all of those things to happen before we even think about retracting these guys. And we accomplished that with the ABBA that I was mentioning earlier. But before we see how the actual one works in the real design, I have the simplified one here, and we can actually see how it gets its name from just the output. So we have A here and B labeled here, and when I push the input, you can see that A lights first, then B, but then when turning off, B turns off first, then A, hence A, B, B, A. So we can see that one more time, A, B, B, A. And yeah, I also have the circuits labeled here just the same way that I do in the real design. So first we have the input, and then let's just say that goes into the lime circuit. First it actually goes into the dual edge, and the dual edge powers the gray circuit, which powers like the 80 whatever pistons that have all one ticking at the same time. But then it also goes into this lime circuit. Let's just say that adds some delay, and that goes into the purple circuit, which was the dull piston extender holding the redstone blocks, but it also goes into this light gray circuit, which I haven't shown you guys yet in the real design. I will in just a second. And what this light gray circuit does is it adds delay from B going into A. So instead of A turning off first, as you can see, that lights up, and this turns off first, and then this turns off. So this just basically locks the cyan circuit. In the actual design, it's the dual edge, so it locks the dual edge, and then it prevents that from turning off before the purple. And we can actually see that right now. So here's that light gray circuit in the actual design, and we also have the lime circuit here feeding into it, just like I had in the simplified diagram. And the way this works is, if you remember at the very beginning, I was talking about how the input powers this piston, and that piston extends and it buds the dual edge. Now the thing about this is we can actually lock this piston. We can keep it extended until the time we want it to. And the way we do that is from this light gray circuit. So instead of turning off the same time the input turns off, this piston has to wait for the light gray circuit to turn off. And you can just see that here. As you can see, it didn't turn off the same time the input did. It had to wait for this dust to turn off instead, because that was also powering the piston. So it has to wait for the input to go, or the item to go back from the hopper into the dropper. It has to wait for the comparator to turn off. It has to wait for these two torches to turn off. And finally, it has to wait for this added three ticks of delay to turn off. And then only then does the piston retract. And that's how we get our delay needed for the ABBA. So yeah, that's it for this video. Hopefully you guys learned something new. After all, that's the goal of this series. And maybe you guys learned a neat little trick that I used in this that you'll use in your future creations. Maybe you learned how this staircase just works in general. Or maybe you just learned the name ABBA, and you can save that for future knowledge whenever you might need to use it. I don't know when that would be, but if you ever do, now you know the term. Anyways, I'd love to hear your guys' feedback once again in the comment section below about this series. Honestly, dissections are my favorite videos to make, so I'll be doing them regardless of what you say. You guys can certainly steer the direction the series is going. Maybe if you want it to be longer or shorter, or if you want me to go into more detail or less detail for whatever reason, you can certainly leave your voice in the comment section below, and I make sure to read every single comment. Even spam bot comments, looking at you, Serena W. Be sure to leave those in the comment section below, and I'll check them out. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and until next time, goodbye.